Kath Hornage was born in 1920, the same year that women in the US gained the right to vote. These two events made 1920 a great year for females. Kath was born 2 years after the World War, and as she grew into a young lady, she might have been thankful not to have experienced a war that involved many of the world's nations. But she hadn't yet left her teenage years before the next World War began. In September of that year, Hitler invaded Poland, and Britain had no option but to get involved. The following year, she met Joe McLinden, who had come to stay at Kath's parents' boarder house in Melbourne's Albert Park. Joe went off to war, but after the war, he returned to Melbourne, and in that year, two mysterious events took place. The first was the famous UFO sighting in Roswell, New Mexico, which had the whole world wondering if alien life forms did indeed exist. The second event, arguably more mysterious, was that Joe plucked up the courage to ask Kath out. 2 years later, they were married. Curiously, in the very same year, Brian arrived. This short period between marriage and motherhood left Catholic leaders scratching their heads. Thankfully, the publication of the Peanut comic strip distracted the world from this controversy. The following year, birth control was developed, an invention that Joe may have wished had arrived 2 years earlier. The following years consisted of athletic feats, more wars, frisbee inventions, iconic American muscle cars, space fascinations, historic elections, and president assassinations. We don't know what Joe and Kath got up to during the swinging 60s, but they did end up having 5 kids, so clearly they had fun. In 69, the world watched as man walked on the moon.
That's one small step for man.
Perhaps inspired by the unlikelihood of a tiny flying object arriving successfully on a remote suspended orb, Brian went about impregnating Vicky. And in 1973, Kath became a grandmother with the arrival of this little chap. Over the next couple of decades, Kath became a grandmother about a dozen more times. While the world ended some wars and started others, her beloved South Melbourne became the Sydney Swans. Space movies and space games increased in popularity. We got our hands on some nifty inventions, disasters occurred, peace had a chance, then lost it again, and pop culture controversies dominated our imaginations. Then, in 2002, Kath became a great-grandma when Sian arrived. This year, 2020, is Kath McLinden's centenary. If she were alive today, and she almost was, she would have lived for 1/10 of a millennium. To celebrate her life and her centenary, I've put together a little video in her honour. I hope you enjoy it. And if you do, don't forget to like this video, hit the notification bell, and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss out on Kath's next centenary video, due to be released in 2120. Nah, I'm joking. I don't have a channel for you to subscribe to, but I do hope you like the video. Let's check it out. Arnie Lorraine. Yeah, she's even responding to it now.
Hey, Dad.
Cool.
Stop wearing that dress, Dad.
Shut up.
People start talking.
Stop it. Just got short for a change.
Looks good.
Yeah, this is quite a community.
About the only one that says it. You and me.
This will be an outing for you guys.
If I say enough, it'll make up for everyone else who isn't saying. Does look good.
Hey, Dad. Oh, God. Oh, good, I'm glad.
Yeah, if you have a wheel on the pants.
It was a bit drastic, a bit of scary.
So who's driving?
Right. Jacko.
They're there?
Yeah.
They're on the front seat.
we're going to do a couple down.
Come in a bus.
Yeah.
How you going?
Oh. Good, thank you.
Full bus?
Yeah.
Happy birthday.
Thanks.
Auntie Lorraine came down. Auntie Lorraine.
Oh, shut up. I've had my hair cut and they reckon they look like I look like Auntie
pretty
Lorraine.
Pretty good. It's the mullet. Oh, my
sister. How was the bus trip?
Good. Went round and round and we thought he was lost.
Oh, he probably was.
No, he said.
Scenic
he
route?
Was told not to have us here till 12, so he got sick of going in circles, so he took us the scenic one.
Fashionably late to
Good afternoon, everybody. It's the speaker. I'll pull away from my mouth a bit.
Can you pass it?
Thanks for coming to Kath's 90th birthday. Look, just a bit of housekeeping. The toilet's down the hallway and to the right. If we need to evacuate, please, no one running. We're going to have entree and then mains, and then after mains, we're going to stop and have a bit of a PowerPoint presentation, and Mum's going to make her second speech in the life, so. So look, everyone enjoy, and if you need anything, give us a yell. Thank you.
Can we expect a speech from you, Nan?
Yes.
Oh, good. Good. Looking forward to it.
But
is it true Pop used to speed when he was driving?
Well, I've been told he has. He could get down to Melbourne without only hit the ground when to go under the bridges.
Did he ever get caught by police?
Yes, he was caught once. The funny thing about it, we were going through a town and this bus was going. We were going the same as this big, not bus, a truck. He went round it. The next thing that followed caught him. I don't know about other times. We were coming home from Melbourne and Helen was driving and she got caught. We'd be only following another car, exactly the same speed. They let him go and caught us.
Used to put your foot down when you were driving?
Yeah,
nah, never.
Yeah.
Stuck to the speed
limit. Film here, I might know.
Yes, ever.
Mum would like to thank everyone who's made the effort to come today. It's been a fantastic lunch. And there's some people that have come a long way to join us. We've and some stars too, I believe the village people are here. And the whole family's here except for Jared, who couldn't make it, but he has been kind enough to send us a message from the White House for a little bit. So, can everyone see that? If you can't turn your chair, get comfy. And so I've seen that look on his face quite often. He'd just been to therapy, I believe. But anyway, here we go. Therese and I extend our warmest congratulations on the occasion of your 90th birthday. It is a major milestone and a time to reflect with pride and satisfaction on a long and fruitful life. In this time, you have witnessed great change and upheaval in the Australian life, and no doubt faced many personal challenges along the way. Australians are greatly indebted to people of your generation for the sacrifices and achievements you have made over the years. as well as for the strong and enduring values of family and community that underpin Australian society. We trust you will enjoy celebrations with your family and loved ones at this special time and wish you many, many more years of health and happiness. Yours sincerely, Kevin Rae, Prime Minister.
I'd like to thank Michelle and John for putting this all together. I would give it a 10 out of 10 effort. Wendy also was roped in somewhere along the line. Thank you, Michael, John and Michelle and Wendy. Thank you, dear family, for coming to help me celebrate my old age. Well, being 90 is getting old. This is only the second time in 90 years that I've been asked to say something. The first time, many years ago, Joe and I were asked to a wedding. We knew the bridegroom very well, and I knew the bride very well. We being involved in parish affairs. The parish prior, Eddie Nugent, must have thought the formal speakers didn't do it well enough and asked the happy couple's friends to say a few words. He thought Kath McLinden could start the ball rolling. I said a few words which I thought would please the bride, but ended up saying, I always found Jean hard to get on with. easy going. It could have been a case of truth will out, and my reputation must have gone ahead of me, as this is the only second attempt. My family, with the exception of Jared and Joel, are with us today. Jared's commitment in Washington kept him in the DC. It would have been a very long lunch for him. Joel also couldn't make it and sends his best wishes. My cousin John is here from Melbourne. I have a very happy life. God gave me loving parents, a brother, grandparents and aunts, and many dear friends. I met my dear Joe 70 years ago. I knew him for 7 years before he asked me to go out. We went to see Johann Strauss, the great waltz.
I advise you to act quickly.
What would you have me do?
Fight! Whatever one wants in this world, one has to fight for. Like the beasts in the jungle. Especially for a man.
It's TLC ever since. We have had a wonderful, happy life. A few clouds from time to time, but always a lot of sunshine. Thank you, Joe. The sun is certainly shining for me today.
Thanks, Mum. Let me say how proud we all are of you. You're the matriarch of this family and we love you dearly. Now, I think we've got the message from Jed. So here's Jed from Washington.
Hi, Mum. Happy birthday and greetings from a very, very cold Washington, D.C. I'm here out the front of my good friend Barack Obama's place. He sends his greetings. In fact, he's giving a State of the Union address tonight and did ask whether he should make mention of your birthday in the address. I suggested not this year, perhaps next year. But it's a big birthday and I'm very sorry I can't be there. Wendy and Timothy and Jonathan will give you a big hug for me. Anyway, it's a very cold day here, so I won't stay long, but something happened to me today which reminded me a lot of your birthday. I was sitting in the credit union, and while I was waiting to be served, I looked at one of these American women's magazines, and I noticed they had a section on horoscopes. Being your birthday, and the fact that you are an Aquarius, I looked up what your year ahead holds for you. I have some good news and some very bad news. Let me start with the good news first. It seems 2010 is a fantastic year if you wish to take up any new sports. It mentions specifically motorcycling and hang gliding. So if this you ever wanted to do that, this is the year for it. Unfortunately, the bad news, and it's bad news, it's a terrible year for romance. I think you're going to be stuck with that for at least another year. Anyway, happy birthday, enjoy it, and I'll see you when I'm back in March. Bye-bye.
You did mention that Barack Obama's peace prizes for actually keeping you and Joe together all these years. He knew about it. Look, I take this opportunity to call on anyone else who would like to say a few words. Well, there's obviously nothing bad to say. Does anyone want to say some good words? Okay. That's it. Well, look, congratulations, Mum. Look, everyone enjoy for a few more minutes and then we'll do the monster cake and some photos. Oh, actually, we can do that now.
Oh, yes, please.
Yes, please. Sorry. Only a couple of minutes put into this preparation for photos. Sorry, I forgot about it.
You must remember this. A kiss is still a kiss. A sigh, just a sigh. And the fundamental things apply as time goes by. No matter what the future brings, as time goes by. Woman needs man, man must have his mate that no one can deny.
What kind of car was that?
There is nothing like a day, nothing in the world. There is nothing you can name that is anything like a day.
Any pictures of fiance?
Brian Short's always been a great choice.
We've got
another fashion story. It's Nana Maruja, I believe. '74, '77. Look what jail did to him. Scruffy or something? Sunny? Sunny? Her favourite place? The end result? The tribe as they were in 1981. Jody, I think. Yeah, they're dead without a tie twice. Josh and Matt. On the cruise, prior to the cruise, dad and dad tie again, but the socks are good. Yeah, mum and dad again, dad's usual beer, nice. Nan and mum again. You notice the bike's inside. Where you met Ruddy? Tokyo? Church? Fancy that. 40th wedding anniversary, nice pants, right? I wonder where the football got to. King of the girls. I think that's the auxiliary, isn't it, mum? At 37 BL. How much have I got there? The hallway. Doubles a football stadium, cricket pitch. Jack. Teague Street and Cook, for those who can't read. I think that's the 50th wedding anniversary.
No, that's
birthday. But
Jack's first. What can I
do? There's a few smart ones in the family. Mum's in front of another cake. And there we go. So we do love you, Mum. That's it. So look, the bus is coming at 4, so let's enjoy each other's company till then. And party on. And the cake. We'll do the cake in a couple of minutes. We've got a couple going, that'll do, Mum reckons. So, look, Mum, happy 90th birthday. So let's all sing happy birthday to Kat.
Happy birthday to you.
Hip it.
Hooray!
Hip it.
Hooray!
Hip it.
Hooray!
Now, can we get one of those younger blokes to blow out the candles? Come here, Megan. Oh, nice. Happy birthday, Mum. Yep. Let's have a look at that knife. All right, who's the boyfriend then?
Give me five.
Yeah, beats. Put your hand up if you don't want cake. Right, good, we got the numbers right then.
Jody, where are the sunglasses? Pop, give us a look. Give us a look at the one. Not bad. Jody, have a crack.
Oh, give you again.
Sorry, now.
Hello, is that on?
No.
I think it is because the red light's on.
Hi, darling. Hello, Sian.
What's Sian's name?
He's now with a woman. He's not working as much. He'd like some custody of us.
Oh, here you go. Say hello to cousin Sian. Say hello. Don't touch the lens.
Da-ba-da.
My name's Mark, and I had a trampoline competition with Sian this morning, and I thought I should have won, but the judge, my mum, Nana Vicky, reckons Sian was better, just because she used a bloody guitar. What do you say, Sian? What do you say to that?
I like my trampoline, and I like to jump on it. Now I'm going to pretend to punch it.
Do you want me to count anything down or
you
got?
Should be right,
okay.
Thank you.
Macca?
I can take
it. Nice to meet you.
Oh,
lovely to meet you.
Okay.
The boys will take
it. Bye, Mal.
Got some flowers, Nat?
Yeah.
Thanks for a lovely day, Nat. That was great.
Yeah, thank you. Okay. What's
chocolate?
Jello.
Jonathan.
Thank you.
Good to have another. Sure. You found it great, Nat. Oh, I have. Six. That's not bad. Bus has got some tunes. Hey.
Dance party music on the bus.
Oh, good.
Stuck here again.
Thank you.
Come on, Pop. They're waiting for you.
Yeah, we're coming.
Dad's been asking about you.
Oh, look, I could have heard that come. One lady had the family.
Well, I'm getting off.
Oh, does Sian get all the kisses, does she?
Beep, beep.
Bye-bye, see you again.
Have we got everybody?
Yeah.
Haven't forgotten anyone?
No, no, not answering.
Haven't purposely left behind Joe and Kath? Sian's back on. Where are you going, Sian? Are you staying on the bus?
Yeah.
All right. See you later.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks, guys. See you later. Thanks for a great day.
She wants to go on the bus.
Yes, Gianni. Say goodbye to Nana. I gave her 19.
This video isn't complete yet. Just as a day with Kath wouldn't be complete without sampling one of her desserts, from scrumptious slices to delicious cakes and addictive cookies, so too is this video not yet complete without one of her famous treats. And surely the most famous of them all was her wine trifle. Her wine trifle was unlike anything I'd ever seen, almost as if every dessert that ever was had been squashed together, creating a confectionery big bang that had all the tastes of Wonka's factory and all the colours of the rainbow, including green. Adding to this mystery was the presence of a dash of brandy, sherry, or wine. Now, for kids who are often denied sugary treats and who were never permitted alcohol, being handed a bowl of this trifle was the food equivalent of being handed the keys to the family car. It was as if all of the rules that governed our childhood had been relaxed for an afternoon. This trifle had become as much of a mystery for me as the picture of Jesus that followed you around as you snuck into Nan and Pop's bedroom. And so I'd eat the trifle, and it tasted how I expected it to taste, like adulthood. Complicated, sweet in parts and strange in others. After finishing the bowl, I'd leave the table confused, unsure of whether I enjoyed the taste of being grown up. I was grateful though, not just for the trifle, but for Nana Kath, and for Pop, and for Nana Thelma. While it was hard to comprehend as a child that people could be so old that their skin wrinkles and their hair turns white, it was easy to perceive their wisdom, to feel it. In this way, grandparents aren't old, they are ancient, as if they've been around forever. And this eternal presence expresses itself as a sense of calmness. That's what Nana Kath gave me, in addition to a $20 check on birthdays. If I'm lucky enough to have grandchildren, I'd like to give them the same sense of calm. I'd also like to give them homemade trifle, just like Nana used to make. So I guess I better learn how to make it. First stop was Google. There were a million different recipes, and as I scrolled, I imagined that if the internet was around for more of Kath's life, she would have surely had a site or a blog about her baking, which would have had a large following. In the absence of kathscooking.com, I had to surf for a while to find something suitable. And since it is the 21st century, where everyone has an allergy or an intolerance, I figured I should make my trifle dairy and gluten-free. Once I found the recipe, it was off to Woolies to find the ingredients. A basket wouldn't suffice. I'd need a trolley. And since I didn't have a $2 coin, I mean, no one carries cash anymore. What is this, 1920? I had to go and find my own trolley. My days of being a trolley boy, though, served me well, and I found one big enough to carry all the ingredients that this mysterious trifle required, like plant milk, maple syrup, baking powder, its close relative bicarb soda, vanilla extract, coconut cream, corn flour, and vegetable oil. These ingredients led me to the aisles that I'd never been in before. Ingredients like sugar and salt, pomegranate juice, apple juice, gelatin, and green food coloring. This was feeling more like a science experiment than a baking expedition. It occurred to me that I hadn't yet been in my favorite section. Thankfully, the recipe did call for lemons, blueberries, and strawberries. Then it was off to Aldi for some gluten-free flour, and then to BWS for the brandy. So this is what a liquor store looks like. I found the cheapest brandy, which was coincidentally named after Nana's year of birth. But since the trifle was going to be gluten and dairy-free, I decided it should probably be alcohol-free too. Plus, it saved me 11 bucks. Then it was off to St. Vinny's to get a glass bowl. So, with everything sourced, I was ready to make the gluten-free, dairy-free, alcohol-free wine trifle. Not quite like Nan used to make. To start with, I had to decide which layer I'd put together first. I decided on whipped cream since it was supposed to go in the fridge for 24 hours, but I figured I could just put it in the freezer for 2 hours instead. Jessie gave me a look of approval. With the cream cooling down, I started on the red and green jelly, which also needed a couple of hours to set. This included water, sugar, and the gelatin. Then I heated it up and added green food dye for the green jelly. It turns out I was only supposed to put 2 drops in, and so my green jelly would likely turn out more like kryptonite. Still, I was too far into it now to stop. I threw some fruit in the red jelly, then popped them both in the fridge. Then came the sponge cake, which had plant milk, oil, really gooey vanilla extract, corn flour, bicarb soda, baking powder, and sugar. It seemed as though I didn't have enough to make a sponge cake, so it was back to the internet. According to the site, I had used the right amount of ingredients, but to be safe, I doubled the dosage. This was more like it, and it passed the taste test. So off to the oven it went for 15 minutes. Just enough time to organise the custard, which included plant milk, lemon juice, more gooey vanilla extract, and corn flour. Then onto the hob it went. To give the custard its custardy colour, try saying that 3 times fast, I added turmeric.
Just a spoonful of turmeric helps the custard go yellow in the most delightful way.
With all the elements either baking, boiling, or cooling, it was time to clear the kitchen, which had seen better days. Even the recipe had taken a battering, which might explain why Nana Kath had been rumoured to have never shared her wine trifle recipe. It simply might not have survived the actual baking. During the cleanup, tragedy struck. Now, maple syrup for vegans is like crack cocaine for druggies, so I ignored COVID recommendations and salvaged as much of it as I could. With the last of the cleaning finished, it was now time to pull all the items together, layer by layer. First went the red jelly, then the sponge, then the cream, then the green jelly, then the custard, and then it was topped with fruit. Well, it may not look as good as Nan's version, but I'm hoping it'll taste just as good. Not bad. But it's not just like Nan used to make. Still, she's had a lot more time to practice.